Access granted.
Hey, think you could fit in a locker? Could smell your fear from here. Come on! Oh.
Are you okay? Let me help you.
I'm tired. It's time to go to bed. Good night, Torch. I hope you don't get stolen. Hello?
It's time for your shot.
Oh, crap. Okay. I'm coming. Hold on. I'll be there in a second. Oh, man. I'm gonna be late. Okay, slow down.
Oh, shoot. You look good.
All right, let's get the torch. What? It's not in here. Oh, crud. The torch, it's not in here. It's gone. I put it in here last night. It's not there. Oh, gosh. No. Guys, we're missing the torch. Y'all are gonna come to my house. It was in my drawer, and I can't find it anymore.
Hey, Dad, we need you to come pick us up. Well, we lost the torch and we need to get to his house really quick. Can you come be here? Okay.
Is it bad?
Oh, no. No, you look good.
Look good.
Colby, we're in.
What happened?
What?
He's lost it?
You got wow, not even surprised.
Oh, my God.
But we have video footage. We can see who took it.
Oh, no.
You know what you did.
What's up, guys?
Don't play dumb. We know everything.
We know you did it.
We have witness at the scene of the crime reporting a bearded creature running away with the torch.
Dude, it wasn't me. You know how I roll.
This guy's good.
Let's get out of here.
Where is it?
Where?
Don't,
what?
Don't talk.
Thanks. All right.
The torch. Do you have it?
Yeah. Walk over here, or if she.
No, I don't have it.
Ride or can't do that. Just
have it. No.
We?
No, you have it.
I don't have it.
Is it in a den? Hurt her?
On a scale of 1 to 1, where is it?
Scale of 1 to 1? Mm-hmm. I don't have it, guys. If you don't leave, I'm going to give you all a detention.
Well, I guess she doesn't have it.
We know you took the torch!
I haven't seen no torch.
Esteban, we can do this the easy way, or we can do it the hard way.
I don't know nothing.
Taylor?
The hard way it is. Chalupa.
Now, Esteban, where's the torch?
Me, yo no sé nada. A mí no me diga nada porque yo no estoy envuelto en nada de estas cosas. Así que vayan.
Not talking, huh?
No, yo no sé nada.
Let's bring in the big guns.
Yo no sé nada.
¿Dónde
está? No, yo no sé nada. A mí no me digan nada. No, déjenme libre. Eso no fui yo, eso fue otra persona. Me dejen solo, por favor.
Seems like he didn't do it. Oh, Esteban! We're sorry. My bad.
We're giving this
one
a
hard time. Hey, we're so cool, right? Esteban, we're getting tacos later? Alright. Sorry.
Hey,
get me out of this! Get me out! Please help!
Eastside boys in the back, what was the deal with Coach Brad?
Nothing.
I don't know.
Jack Squat. What was the deal with Mrs. Denver?
Nothing.
Suspicious.
And we already know the deal with Esteban.
Couldn't understand.
No. I have no idea how to speak Spanish. First, read a passage that's found in Matthew, and then I will go from there.
So this is Matthew 22:33. Immediately he made the disciples get into the boat and go before him to the other side, while he dismissed the crowds. And after he had dismissed the crowds, he went up on the mountain to by himself to pray. When evening came, he was there alone. But the boat by this time was a long way from the land, beaten by the waves, for the wind was against them. And in the fourth watch of the night, he came to them walking on the sea. But when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified and said, "It is a ghost," and they cried out in fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them, saying, "Take heart, it is I, do not be afraid." And Peter answered him, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." And he said, "Come." Focus on this part. So Peter got out of the boat and walked on water and came to Jesus. And when he saw the wind, he was afraid. And beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Jesus immediately reached out his hand and took hold of him, saying to him, "Oh, you little faith, why did you doubt?" And when they got into the boat, the wind ceased. And those in the boat worshipped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." So, one thing that I've learned this year, the crazy year that it's been, with Harvey and people passing and just school itself, I learned that focus is everything. Where we place our mind and our eyes is very important. Your perception of the world and your perception of what life looks like determines your direction that you're going to go. And there's really only two things that you can look at. So in this story, we'll first focus on when you look at the waves. So it says, when Peter saw the wind, he was afraid. So I think this is very applicable to our life. When we look at the waves, when we look at our sea and our craziness of life, we become afraid. We become disoriented, afraid, and anxiety-filled. But we look and we see that when Peter looks at Jesus, this is so cool. This is something that I learned like just reading this, and I've read this 1,000 times, but this is something that I've gotten from this. So it says, Peter got out of the boat and walked on water and came to Jesus. Walking on water is impossible. When we look at Jesus, something that feels so impossible becomes possible. And John 16:33 says, "I have said these things to you so that you may have peace. In this world you will have tribulation, but take heart because I have overcome the world." Jesus promises that we will have storms and we will have crud things happen to us. It's just life. It just happens. Like I said previously, we have had really a cruddy year with Harvey, tons of people passing, school, drama, everyday things that get in the way of life. But it says, "I have overcome the world." So my challenge to the juniors, to parents, to staff and faculty, to the seniors, there will be things that will get in your way this next year, in your whole life. But my challenge is to you, whatever your storm, whether it be big or small, whether it's everyday stress, whether it's something big, something small, look to Jesus. Evaluate where your focus is. Look to our Father, not to make things easier, but to make things possible. Let me pray for you guys and then turn your attention to the screen. Jesus, we thank you so much for today. We thank you just for letting the seniors finish. It's a big deal. God, we thank you for these upcoming juniors. God, I pray just leadership in their hearts. I pray for a peaceful year this next year that would be fun. I pray that you would walk before us and that you would have our hand this next year. God, we thank you and we love you so much. Thank you for your sacrifice. And God, if someone does not know you in this room, that you would speak to them right now in this moment. God, we love you and we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. Turn your attention to this.
First day of senior year when Taylor left her brand new Chromebook on the top of my car, the hood, and then we went to school and it drove off, so we had to go back and find it in the middle of a road, and we were almost late to the first day of school.
Whenever I met my best friend Mary Grace in eighth grade.
The senior night halftime performance with the senior cheerleaders, and we did a cheer. And then we did a stunt, and I was a flyer for the first time ever in front of all these people, and I was terrified. And then our dads came, and we did a goofy dance with them, and they did a stunt with Jamie's dad as a flyer. And then on the way off the field, my dad attempted two cheer jumps, and it was hilarious.
Last year,
after the 7th grade class made the wonderful executive decision to trash the new locker room with chocolate milk, and Coach Williams went and got the preschool leash and made him walk all the way to the lunchroom twice because someone didn't hold on the first time.
The time Ethan DeGraff fouled up a offensive lineman drill, Coach Sink wanted to redo a play, and he went like this to redo, but then he started the play and Ethan DeGraff started rolling on the ground and he got up and Coach Sink was really mad.
Last year in physics, whenever I was trying to blow bubbles in my water bottle through a straw and it all came back and exploded in my face.
When we were rolling out the softball tarp out in the softball field, and Jenny, we were rolling it so fast that she ended up like rolling over it and falling onto the ground.
When I was back in junior high, Mr. Vanderbilt told all of us that the next person to call Noah Nar would get a detention. And then Vaughn walks in late into class, and the first thing he says, "Hey, what's up, Nar?"
is when we were at lunch one day, and I said, "Jamie, I have to tell you a secret," because she was across the table from me. And so she leaned in. Well, I didn't know that I had to sneeze. So when she leaned forward, I sneezed all over her face, and she got really mad at me.
Okay, so last year, during lunchtime, Eric smashed down on a sauce packet and it got all over the girls on the next table.
Me and Anna were in junior high on the basketball team, and this girl was getting on Anna's nerves, and so Anna took the girl and threw her into the wall. And of course, you know, Anna got fouled out that game like usual.
We were in biology and we had like this tub of colored pencils, and Miss Pratt asked K. Tyra to pass them out, and he was taking like a long time, so finally Miss Pratt asked him why he was taking so long, and he was like, "Miss Pratt, I'm colorblind." And she was like, "Well, I didn't know." And he was like, "I thought you were making fun of me." And yeah, that was pretty funny.
When we went on a band trip with Brandon Sewell and they tightened his roller coaster harness down too far and he was screaming and hollering every turn.
I went to the band trip last year, and I decided to ride some roller coasters for the first time, and at the top of the Iron Rattler, I yelled out, "I have made a horrible mistake."
I'm a race watching Napoleon Dynamite at Mallet's house for the first time.
Memories when within a month of getting the new workout room and the new workout equipment, I went to adjust it by pulling one of the knobs and it came unscrewed in my hand, and we couldn't adjust that rack for the rest of the year.
The LSA in basketball and overtime my junior year.
When we went to state playoffs my freshman year.
In a 7th period economics, Coach Hamilton was saying the days, and he said "mimi day" instead of "meme day."
When I hit that full court shot on my senior night, because, you know, it ain't every day you see somebody hit a full court shot on your senior night. And so now I'm playing outro. All right.
Sophomore year when we beat Baytown and Coach Sherrod threw a bunch of chicken nuggets on the floor and we stomped on them.
Connor and Harrison were debating on whether a pencil would make an outlet explode, and Harrison said he wouldn't, and then he showed the pencil in the outlet and it exploded everywhere and sparks flew all over their pants.
On the soccer team with Coach Atwell, we knew when to be serious and when to have fun.
In 7th grade, we went to Irkham's Lake and got rained out for 4 hours and decided to sit in a giant building. So that was fun.
In band camp, when Miles Blackshear came up behind Mr. Gray and tied little knots in his dreads, and he didn't find them for like 2 months.
I was in Bible this year, and I went to go present something on my Chromebook, and I stepped over a backpack and tripped and cut my whole eyebrow. And I got up, and it just started gushing blood, and I ended up having to go get it, like, closed.
When Sam, Holly, and Sarah were the school mascots.
Is when we beat Northern in football.
Freshman year, going to state, being the only team to go to state during football.
So my favorite memory is I've been a student here since 2008 and I haven't left. And everyone thinks I'm a teacher, but I'm really a student. This beard is fake. I know Demi Lovato, went to breakfast this morning at Cracker Barrel with her. She ate more biscuits than I've ever seen. I didn't know a dancer could eat that many biscuits, but Demi Lovato, she loves biscuits, and that's my favorite memory here at Bay Area.
She's so bright.
Man,
most likelies. Okay, starting in pre-K, Grant, most likely to be the next Dave Ramsey. All right, next up, Jacob Steele, most likely to have people make puns of his last name. Hey, Jacob, you're going to steal that base tonight?
Yes, and I'm going to steal Grant's heart. Sup?
Okay.
All right, AJ, most likely to overdose on coffee. Coming in kindergarten, Madeline Yates, most likely to write a children's book. All right, coming in first grade, Anna, most likely to fire the kids referee.
That's a tech, Anna. One more time and you're out.
Hailey came in first grade, and she is most likely to start an animal rescue program.
Jamie, most likely to always be early. All right, coming in third grade, Colby, most likely to become a little league coach.
Andrew also came in third grade. He's most likely to become a drill sergeant.
Drop and give me 20, Colby!
Coming in fourth grade, Ryan, most likely to never take off his sweatshirt. All right, coming in fifth grade, Carson, most likely to become an HEB store manager.
Thank you for shopping at HEB. We're here. Everything is better. Nicholas Coons also came in fifth grade, and he is most likely to narrate a movie.
Tis but a flesh wound.
Christina, most likely to put Hostess out of business. Coming in sixth grade, Colton, most likely to never get another pair of shoes.
Can't get rid of a holy pair of shoes.
Taylor came in 7th grade, and she is most likely to lose her baby on the way home from the hospital.
That's what I was reading. Thank you. Give her kids ice cream for breakfast. Yum. All right, Lainey. Lainey, most likely to be a broke comedian.
Why does Snoop Dogg need an umbrella? For drizzle.
Go sit down.
Megan came in 8th grade, and she is most likely to never get her driver's license.
Can anybody give me a ride home after this?
Coming in 9th grade, Julianne, most likely to miss graduation for a doctor's appointment. Julianne.
Sorry.
Oh, Juju. I know, sorry. Also coming in 9th grade, Malin Kubicki, most likely to be on Survivor.
Your tribe has spoken.
Tate came in 9th grade, and he is most likely to not study.
Coming in 10th grade, Chris, most likely to be a game critic.
Fortnite is trash. It's only popular because it's free.
All right, on to the Boston. Most likely to never win at Marco Polo.
It's because I can't hear.
Taylor Anderson also came in 10th grade, and she is most likely to never cut her hair.
Oh yes, luscious. Coming in 11th grade, Cameron, most likely to be a sports broadcaster.
Going, it's gone.
Also come in 11th grade, Anthony, most likely not to graduate high school.
Come on, get up. This is my spot.
Anthony also has a message for the upcoming seniors. I already have my assigned seats for next year, so if you try to take my seat, catch me outside. How about that?
Colin also came in 11th grade, and he's most likely to own a coffee shop in Rado.
Bryce, most likely to not have a most likely.
Falby also came in 11th grade, and she is most likely to be a famous artist.
Perfect. Magnificent. All right, last but not least, coming in 12th grade, Echo, most likely to become a roast master. Yes, Echo.
Come on, Echo. Come on, Echo. Give it to me.
Where's Lainey? Hey, Lainey. Calculus is fine. It's fun and it's easy. Why do you drop it?
That's a good one. Okay.
Now turn your attention to the screen for the senior slideshow.
I always knew this day would come. We'd be standing one by one with our future in our hands. So many dreams, so many plans. I always knew after all these years there'd be laughter, there'd be tears. But never thought I'd walk away with so much joy but so much pain. And it's so hard. Chapter in the book, can't go back, but you can look. And there we are on every page, memories I'll always save. Up ahead, only open doors. Who knows what we're heading towards? I wish you love, I wish you love. For you, the world just opens up, but it's so hard. We'll smile and we'll laugh, but right now we just cry.